like an island boy, but it ain't fred, cause I keep me a vest on. Get down like the Backstreet Boys, cause it make you dance, but you better get your groove on.
And I'm not talking about, but it too strong. Talking, then we get it started, pull up in the U-Haul, you get your move
and
on.
And they know they ain't seeing us. You pull your opinion, I double cup. Wanna step at yourself, are you good enough? Wanna step at yourself, are you hood enough? If I hear them kids, know you pulling up. And now you laid out, they don't get enough. I'm with your girl in the bathroom, and it sound like shit.
I try that little boy, ain't no getting up. Shorty, your horsey, I told her they my young city, yo. The granny, I had to tell her, pick it. You wanna feed, not anything under 18. Just like, Madden from the club, she like 5'3". I think it ain't Lydia.
You know you're unstoppable, man, it's impossible to stop as we for sure on the road. Stay to myself, stay off the medium. Chilling, ain't gonna play with the troll.
With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. This fielded right at the goal line. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. They'll start here with Jackson. And he'll power his way up near the 25. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down.
At the 24-yard line.
Here's Aikman setting to throw it. Got a man. It's Randy Moss complete. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. That's a gain of 13, first down Rams.
We came into this one focused on Randy Moss, and now he has our full attention with his first grab of the game.
Well, he's one of only two players to go a whole season averaging over 100 yards receiving and average a touchdown per game as well. That's a pretty impressive stat.
It really is, especially when you consider that every defense he faced was prepared for him and was kicking coverages in his direction.
A big play there for LA. 48 yards.
Execution was one of their watchwords leading up to this one. And on that play, able to execute brilliantly here on this opening drive.
They run on first down with Jackson. Yeah, he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
On second down, here's Aikman. He'll dump this to Ball. It's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. And that's going to lead to a third down. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area. But they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game. But they must like the matchups they're getting.
Call it a 4-yard pickup, but it leaves him a few inches short here on fourth down. Decision made for Sean McVay. They're going to go for it. Here we go on fourth down. They only get a hard-fought yard, but that's all they needed. It pays off, the decision to go for it, first and goal. And this play's still live. He faked the spike, going to throw it. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive. Second and goal from the 1. Jackson. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Calling a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing.
And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown. A touchdown run there from a yard out. And the Rams are on the board first on the road here in Baltimore. And that caps off what was really a balanced opening drive for them, Charles. They work in the rushing game and the aerial attack, and they end it with a touchdown.
Strong in so many ways, wasn't it, partner? Their ability to throw it and run it and accomplish their goal, they've got to like the way that they started this ball game.
Now after the touchdown, ready to boot it away, Riley Dixon. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10, just shy of the 30. They start the drive with Lynch. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
A good run there off right tackle in an old-school NFL football. The right side, the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 13-yard gain yet again, just like last play.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we...
And looking for Andrews, but this is intercepted. Jalen Petrie picks it off. Down to the 10, and he will bring it back. It's an interception return for a Rams touchdown. We thought this defense would be opportunistic, and they were. Here, you're already up. Now you got a 2-touchdown lead. I tell you, going out there on defense, did they have a little bit of extra momentum with a score already on the board?
Oh, without a doubt. That already felt good to them, and they took it and used it and obviously put up another one. But here's the thing now. Some defense coordinators might want to pull their guys back a little bit because they don't want them to make mistakes because they're too overamped. Others say, I've got 2-touchdown lead. Go get them, guys. They'll be even more aggressive.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30.
The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They find themselves in a good-sized hole here, and a good-sized hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
And a big gain that time. He's out of bounds on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Second quarter now from Baltimore. It's the Ravens in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. They go with Lynch right side. Oh, that one well designed as he'll take this down to the 30-yard line. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
He'll keep pounding here with Lynch. And a strong run there as he'll maneuver his way down inside the 15. 48 yards rushing for him now. He's only carried the ball 4 times.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays. 3 first downs?
That's a pretty good recipe for success. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Marshawn Lynch, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Ravens have cut it back within a score. bouncing back nicely from that bad opening drive where he threw the interception. Drive number two leads him right down the field and into the end zone.
So obviously his confidence was never lost, and that's a good thing to see. Great quality to have. You absolutely must maintain that as a quarterback. But I have to think that they're probably still on the script that they prepared for this game. Just the second drive, they've worked on these plays all week in practice. Put them to good use on that one.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
The Rams take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated grooves. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jalen Jackson. And the return will stop right around the 25.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
Yo. Middle. Hey, Ozzie.
First down, the run with Lynch. And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
On second down, Lynch. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. It's a good gain of 11, sets them up first and goal.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? Second and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. Again, they'll pound it with Lynch. Showed off the toughness, but still corralled shy of the 5 at the 6. A short gain of just over 2 yards as the first half clock dips inside of 3 minutes. To throw is Jackson. And he's going to go down, sacked back at the 13-yard line. Following the sack, they go from the 13 on third and goal. Jackson. Got a man, it's caught for the Ravens touchdown. George Kittle from 13 yards out. And the Ravens are an extra point away now from moving out in front. No surprise there. Third and goal down here. That's where they're going to look for their tight end.
Yeah, you want that big guy running his routes because it doesn't matter who they cover him with. If it's another big guy, he might use his bulk against him. If it's a shorter defender, might go over the top. Either way, you tend to find a little bit of a mismatch in that area.
Tucker with the extra point. And with it, his guys take the lead here by a point. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Los Angeles offense set to begin their next drive.
For this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back, but make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Caught by Allen. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. That'll go for a gain of 7. And that's going to make it fourth down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Fielded just inside the 20. Nearly a huge return, as it is still a very good one. 24 yards, and the Ravens, they'll take over. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They're starting to pull away with this one. Early on that first quarter, they didn't look so great offensively. What has changed?
Sometimes it's just a matter of doing what you plan to do better. Sometimes you just put that all together and you execute. Other times it's just a simple adjustment in your game plan, finding a spot that maybe was a little weaker than maybe you thought, and going to that. So many different things, so many different ways, but right now, you gotta like what they're doing. They have put distance between themselves and their opponent.
Looking to add on here in the second quarter. They'll throw on first down with Jackson. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. And quickly, they get to the line.
A loss of 6. Brings up second.
Now it's Jackson. That'll be caught by the big tight end, Andrews. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 29-yard line. The Ravens get a new set of downs, give them 17 on that pickup.
First and 10 at the 29-yard line.
The 10th carry of the game for Marshawn Lynch. Powers through, trucks over it, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. 119 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they move the ball with relative ease.
Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action.
DC,
two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Now Jackson. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Throwing is Jackson. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Now a timeout. 7 seconds left in the first half.
So that now 4 first half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
And partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's the game plan that they've had so far, because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
Third and goal, and still a long way from the end zone. Here's Jackson to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. Jamar Chase in the final seconds of the first half. And the Ravens will extend their lead here just before halftime.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. Tucker now for the extra point. And with that, the lead is up to 8. 4 seconds, all that remain here this first half as the kick gets away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with only 4 seconds on the clock, time likely for just one snap of the football. Throw right side, going to be complete to Moss. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. Taking it about the one. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
Jackson and the Ravens come up now, first and 10 at their own 27. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And this is going to be hauled in by the tight end Andrews. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
So one play and they're already just shy of midfield. Now Lance running right. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take him in short, steady bursts.
Takes this to the 45. Not much space after that broken tackle. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Jackson. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Now let's see. Yeah, the offense still out there. They elect to go on 4th and 11. They'll indeed go for it with Jackson. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he is going to have a Ravens first down, and they come up with a big one there to keep the drive moving and then some.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. What a great effort there. He's going to get this inside the 15, and they'll spot it at the 13-yard line. Nice run. 139 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. They'll run again with Lynch. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. They'll run for it with Lynch. Nothing doing there. They're going to wind up holding him at the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. So stuffed from the 2, now what?
You know me pretty well. What do you think I want here?
Play action?
Definitely. Let him get outside and create. And if he has to run it, he has a little bit more spin.
And that'll be taken in by Andrews for a Ravens touchdown. 2 yards on the touchdown there. And the Ravens take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and the lead is up to 15 now. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. and taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. The L.A. offense ready to go for their next drive. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
Baltimore, third quarter action, second and 10. Aikman now off the bootleg. Little pitch and catch to the tight end, Knox. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take what you can get situation. Got out to the tight end, now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
And they're able to stop him short. On third and 6, they'll only pick up 4.
They still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on fourth down, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and run for it. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down.
First down, Los Angeles.
Looking to pass, Aikman on first down. His throw incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Second and 10 now, it's Aikman. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. The veteran Kyle Van Noy in there to drop him.
That's a ball he needs to let go of there. Wasn't the most time in the world to work through his progression, but NFL quarterbacks, they've got to sense the pressure. They've got that internal clock, and the ball has to be gone. And if you're not going to escape and run for it, you have to let it go before the pressure gets to you and puts you on the ground.
Now Aikman, third and long. And that one knocked away and incomplete. Nice job defensively on what will be the final play of the third quarter. Back now in Baltimore. It's the Rams trailing, but they do have the football as we start the fourth and final quarter. They're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They'll try and throw for it with Aikman. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. No luck for the Rams as they fail here on fourth down. And boy, possession here turns over with a football already being in the red zone. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Now a give running right is Lynch. And he'll get 7 yards from the 17 to the 10 before he's taken down. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up first and goal. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Here's Jackson. Throw left side, complete. That's Lynch. Touchdown! Marshawn Lynch. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Ravens have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. Boy, he has been fun to watch throwing the ball.